I always think that they're images of sensation. After all, what is life but sensation? What we feel, what happens.
What happens at the moment?
What happens at the moment.
What do you think of that reaction when people say your paintings are ugly? What do you think of that?
Well, I'm very pleased. I'm genuinely pleased that those people don't like them. I mean, that would be the greatest condemnation if any of them liked them. So I'm much more pleased when they really hate them than when they like them. After all, it means that there might be something there if they really dislike them. I want to give me a shock. Now, shock, you could say, is a form of expression. But what expression it is, I don't know. It's a visual shock. It's not a shock that you could get from a story. It's just a visual shock.
So what is it that you're presenting when you've finished?
Nothing except what people want to read into it. Nothing. Well, the thing is, what horror, what could I make to compete? If you know what's going on in the world, what could I do to compete with the horror that's going on? Except that I have tried to make images of it, and I have tried to recreate it and make not the horror, but I've tried to make images of realism. Everything I do, I work very quickly. You see, when I do these paintings, I have had an overall idea of what I want to do, but as I'm always hoping the chance is going to work in my favour, I don't try to read my work. I don't really know what it means.
So you're resisting telling a story? I mean, that is not telling a story.
Very, very much so. I don't want to tell a story. I have no story to tell. I like the starkness of the image. We are animals, aren't we? We are just part of animal life.
Been the extraordinary photographs which have been done of animals just being taken up before they were slaughtered. And I think these pictures were very much based on that kind of thing, which to me is very, very near this whole thing of the crucifixion. I know for religious people, for Christians, the crucifixion has a totally different significance. But as a non-believer, it has just an act of man's behavior, way of behavior to another.
The subject of meat is such a marvelous subject matter. And of course, naturally, meat has enormous overtones to it. If you go to some of these great stores, where you just go through these great halls of death, you can see meat and fish and birds and everything else all lying dead there.
I could say that you're always aware of it. I mean, you're always aware of it. It's just round the corner for you. But I don't think about it because there's nothing to think about. When it comes, it's there. I've had it.
But you have an acute sense of mortality, don't you?
Well, don't you think everybody has? Impulse is my life. My impulse is that I'm an old man, but I'm profoundly optimistic about nothing.
How can you be optimistic about nothing, Francis?
I can be.
Why?
Just existing for a moment. Existing today makes me optimistic.
Optimistic about what?
Nothing. I'm optimistic about nothing. I'm just born with that kind of optimistic nature. I'm just optimistic about nothing.
Don't.